I'm Dr. Sathe, professionally an anesthetist and passionately a social worker. Combining both the lives is not a difficult task. Watch this film.
Alexa, how are you?
Couldn't be better. Oops. I mean better. The tongue twister seemed to have got my tongue.
Alexa, how many oceans are in the world?
There are 5 oceans.
Alexa, thank you.
This is not a fantasy. This is a reality. Innovative use of Alexa in a rural school by a rural primary teacher, Mr. Naganath Vibhute. Exemplary work done by the Bombay Mothers and Children Welfare Society, an organization established 100 years back, 1919, by a visionary Dr. Bapusaheb Maskar. I took over as a secretary of the trust in 1985. Charity with a tag not for profit was not acceptable to me. Not for loss was a proud tag to wear. I transformed the charity into a sustainable social enterprise. Friends, staying in a city, we do not know about the ground realities into a rural area or a Bharat where 60% of our population stays. I also was like you. My connect with the rural area was once in a year visit to this slide, like to drink plenty of Ganneka juice when a jaggery making factory used to work over there. Naturally, I knew nothing about rural life, lifestyle, and their problems. I had a passion in mind to work for the rural communities, but never knew how to start, when, and where. Till one teacher offered me a motorcycle ride deep into a tribal village of Rajvetale. Started moving on a bumpy and dusty roads, surrounded by vast barren hills, dilapidated houses, and dirt all around. Suddenly I was in a steep incline, going towards the village. As we were approaching the village, the journey was suddenly become better with the melodious sounds of poems recited by the tribal kids. At the entrance, we were welcomed by the government school. Government school with 2 teachers, 2 classrooms, only for 25 children. I was stunned. I was aghast by the deep reach of the government. The critic in me had an instant death over there. I decided to be positive and start working constructively. Rural education is in shambles. Today, 97% of Indians get a chance to school within 1 kilometer radius. But what is the condition? 47% of 5th standard students cannot read a 2nd standard book. A miserable condition. We thought of working on it. Well, sitting in a city at the top of the pyramid, the usual discussed problems were bad infrastructure, poor quality teachers. But now, I was at the bottom of the pyramid. Wearing their shoes, I was moving in the villages. And what our perspective was, absentee due to a bad, dry, and disinterested curriculum. That was the problem. Demotivated teachers, walking into empty classrooms. Uneducated parents never knew what the education is going to impact about the child's future. City-centric curriculum with no relevance to the rural area. An agrarian country don't teach agriculture to the rural schools. Unforgivable paradox. Now with this set of inferences, we were ready to launch our education program. To make the education interesting, technology was the key. We started talking to technological experts. They said e-learning is the solution, but cautioned me about non-availability of internet. Passionate worker we were, and we were convinced about the change that we want to make. We searched hard till we got a digital animated curriculum which can be delivered without internet. 72 schools were on a digital platform in next 3 months. My board supported my vision by allowing me to divest our corpus and allowing it to deprived kids. The classroom was converted into a cinema hall. 100% attendance was a reality. Teachers were very happy with this teaching aid. Enthusiasm among the parents, looking at the child studying at home and reciting the poem, was unbelievable. They themselves came to the school and saw the program. Now, they were thinking that yes, our child's future can change with this education. The smile on their face and their conviction about the child's education was the biggest gain of this program. We started feeling very happy and elated. But sooner, the neighboring villages people, they started coming and pressing upon us for the similar facility. We were happy with the demand generation, but finance was a problem. We wanted to do something for them also, so we decided to develop a new model. Now this new model was based on the PPP, which all business people know as a public-private partnership. We changed the terminology and say public, philanthropy, and the person, wherein philanthropy is a mediator, public is a government school, and the person does an impact investment into the school. I started talking with this model to my friends and relatives, and they were very happy and they said, yes, we can do it. Now I went back to the villagers and said, look, people are ready to invest. Are you willing to participate? They were very happy for the change that is going to happen. 15% contribution from the villagers was instantaneous. They also agreed to make it sustainable by paying a small fee of rupees 10 per child per month for a maintenance and sustenance. Now, this PPP model was converted into a sustainable participatory PPP model. It gathered the speed, and in 5 years, my dear friends, we have 280 digital schools into a rural India. We took help of the IIT graduates. They had a startup into an alternative energy. They designed a small powerhouse for a rural school. Same PPP model was applied, and today, in just 2 years, 240 rural schools are on a solar power. So solar and digitally empowered schools, entire education scenario into rural area was changing. The divide between the urban and the rural was decreasing, but the personality was the problem. How to develop a person when he is not exposed? So we decided to take help of a mythology. In mythology, it is said that exposure to all form of arts is a personality development. We started dance, drama, music, drawing, self-defense with the help of a local talent and a YouTube. And my tribal rural kids started looking confident. Enthused with this, we decided to tinker their minds. We gave them 600 science videos wherein you can make the experiments from a waste material. The response was huge. They started making the experiments from a waste material, and it compelled us to hold the science exhibitions. For the last 5 years, we are holding the science exhibitions wherein We have 70 odd schools coming in and participating with 150 to 200 projects. Now this was done, and we started thinking what next can be done to make them better. Spring in the fields, my workers were moving into the villages. They came back and said, "Sir, tribal kids coming into the school early in the morning look hungry. The hunger pang is visible on his face. Can you change it? Can you do something about it?" We thought of same PPPP model. The cost of the breakfast was very small, but cost of the logistics was killing. We invoked the teachers, asked for their help. They came in with a absolute full power. They carry 1 week's quota of the breakfast on Monday morning to the school. Last 5 years, we are giving a breakfast to 1,000 children without a day's gap. 4 rupees a day, 100 rupees a month, 1,000 rupees a year. Many middle class families came forward and supported this program. Everybody wants to give back to the society. A small packets bring even the middle class people into a donation. They are very happy. With all these things done, now we were looking realistically about the tribal kids. The mainstreaming of the tribal kids is not to bring them to the city. The mainstreaming is that expose them and make them as good as the city child is. So we started thinking upon how we can teach them the technology and the computers. Every child was handling the e-learning system. The keyless school were absolutely a reality. The keys of the schools are now with the children and not with the teacher. So we decided to teach them the technology. We talked to the teachers. They liked the idea. We developed a small computer van with 6 computers in that, and we were about to start. The teacher said, "Sir, language is going to be the barrier. The tribals speak a different language and they will not identify with your language." So we decided to choose an Adivasi boy, trained him into a driving, trained him into a computers. The cost of the project was halved because the same person was doing both the things. Language barrier gone. Now it was a happy learning. That boy in last 3 years has trained 1600 tribal kids. They are digitally empowered. After all doing these things, the problem of an agrarian community not being taught about the agriculture was still pinching, still hurting. How can you change that? Unless they are taught about the modern agriculture, their income is not going to improve. They are going to remain economically backward. Are we ready to do that? Should we introduce to a elder people to a high school or to a primary school was the question. We decided that we will start at the primary school because entry from the primary level into a parent's heart, we knew how it happened into an education. So we decided to give a small hydroponic unit to every school for the children to play with. We are experimenting and we are becoming experts in it. From next year, we will start giving a hydroponic unit for the children to play with. They will grow the vegetables and they will use those vegetables into their midday meal. End-to-end solution is the hallmark of Bombay Mothers and Children Welfare Society's programs. Alexa, 40 schools will have an Alexa as an infotainment system. There is nobody to give them the information. They have a lot of questions, but person-to-person interactions, they get scared. They are not exposed. But with a third party or an inanimate thing, they talk very freely. You saw in the film. So that is how it is going to happen. 40 schools will have the Alexa now, and they will be on a completely digital platform. My dear friends, I am here today not to tell what I have done. The important thing is that the model that we have created, can be convertible everybody's sympathy into a compassionate empathy. Only 23% of the Indians get an opportunity to reach up to the higher education. Do we rest have the onus to bring remaining 77% to our level? Are we prepared to do that? Can this model help you to convert your sympathies into an compassionate empathies? You don't require an organizational support. You walk from the city on any direction, just 2 kilometers, and you will find a Jilla Parishad school. I give you a challenge that majority of them, they are not in a good health. You decide to improve it, come back to the city, talk to your friends, talk to your relatives, collect the money and improve your school. Panchayat Raj Act 1985 has a Gram Sabha as an empowered body. The Gram Sabha decision is binding on the government to a certain extent. They do a resolution and hand it over to the Panchayat Samiti and it is done. To me, nationalism is not me, myself and my country. To me, nationalism is me, my country and my participation. Can it be a participatory nationalism? Every educated person decides to change one school. I'm sure the India will change in next 5 years as far as the rural education is concerned rapidly. And believe me, as Victor Hugo has correctly said, you open the door of the school and you close the door of the prison. How true it is. Do you have to become a saint to do all these things? No. You can live your life king size and still invest your thought process into the communities. I have done that for last 35 years. No compromises on any aspect of your life has been done. So, please come forward. Ultimately, power of one. It requires one person, one moment, and one compassion to start a ripple of change. Thank you very much, my dear friends.